So what's in this message?
I don't know.
It will not be used as some stooge for violence.
All I know is that Bobby Sands needed to get a message out.
Well, I'm going to read this bloody message. Give me that. Give me that. That's IRA business. Give it to Mrs. Quigley.
No. My friend, the Brits have finally forced us to live in our own dirt. The lad's morale is collapsing.
If you cannot find a solution, then we must push this crisis to its conclusion by going on hunger strike.
I'm not threatening you, but stating the cold reality. Your friend and comrade, Bobby Sands.
Tell me about working with her. I mean, she was... We know how good you are, but she was...
Yes, she was wonderful. You know, Fionnuala lives in America, in Los Angeles,
yeah.
But she's very active within the Irish Republican movement in America and a great supporter of Republicanism. I'm British, so it was not that we come from opposite sides, far from it, because I'm also a supporter of Republicanism in a sense.
When you say you're a supporter of Republicanism, what does that mean?
Well,
you want to see Northern Ireland become part of the Republic of Ireland?
Get away from me.
What is this time? I'm coming up your nose, Helen.
You're getting up my nose now, Charlie.
Just exactly what is it you're saying, Miss Merritt? You know? I mean, what are your politics? If you want to make a movie, you owe it to us to tell us what your politics are.
Ireland,
you can't escape this by being some artist.
I believe in Ireland as an independent country. It is luckily now an independent country. I don't think...
Well,
anyway,
we all believe in Ireland being an independent country. It is an independent country.
Yeah.
The question is whether you believe that Northern Ireland should be part of the Republic of Ireland and whether the British ought to have some remaining connection with Northern Ireland, isn't it?
I don't know. Okay. I think I know what will happen.
That's what I want to know. What do you think will happen?
I think that eventually Ireland will be united. That's what I think.
It'll be part of Europe like all the rest of Europe, and, you know, we'll all be European.
Come back to Europe, because I know you're more than, I mean, you've had some real involvement in this.
Yeah, I have, yeah.
Did it's you go to prison? How long?
3 years.
3 years?
Mm, long case.
What did you do?
I was arrested for a firearms offense. I was in a car and someone was carrying guns and everyone in the car was sentenced, found guilty. And
did you know nothing about it?
Well, I knew the guy who was in the car was, you know, an activist.
Like
and
yeah.
And either did or didn't, so it wasn't that I didn't know anything about it, but...
And what did that experience do to you?
Well, it gave me a career, strangely enough.
So you began to write about the IRA and...
Well, it was writing about more than that. It was writing about the experience of a divided society. So, but yeah, it was a bizarre place because the place that I was in was a prisoner of war camp. It had, you know, gun towers and soldiers with dogs and spotlights and little Nissan huts and barbed wire and people who marched around and behaved like prisoners of war.
And you were treated as a prisoner of war.
Yeah, political status it was called, and it was the removal of that recognition that led to the
hunger strike. Mm. Yeah,
but it was, I mean, within Northern Ireland, it was all these strategies that were designed to solve the problem rather than getting to the peace table.
I interrupted Helen. Helen thinks that, in fact, that there will be, you know, a uniting of Northern Ireland into Ireland, fair to say.
Yes.
What you just said, and you believe that too, or you would sort of say, well, we'll all be in Europe, so...
But, I mean,
with a common currency.
That sounds like a wishy-washy way
it
of
does.
Getting out of it, but in fact, if you've been to the south of Ireland lately, they're so Europe, they've benefited so much from the European Union that evolution now is a part...
In terms of economics.
And socially and culturally as well, they have a European perspective that has changed the place quite dramatically in the last 20 years. And so that evolution could take place if we weren't bogged down in the particular political division that exists or not.
You like this directing thing?
Yeah, a lot. Yeah, it's a control freak thing.
It's easy. Look what you had to work with. I mean,
it is.
This
that's
was
true.
Not hard.
Yeah. It's just keeping the stamina.
You
out.
Made it for about $8 million, did I read, or yeah. much more? About eight.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Yeah.
Are you making more Prime Suspects?
No, I've done my last one. But the last one's going to air here, I think, in February.
Why did we have to stop this?
Because things have to come to an end, and it's better for them to come to an end while they're still hot and good and creative
yeah.
than when they're not anymore. And it was time for me to move on.
Like John Cleese said, I stopped making Fawlty Towers because I realized I couldn't keep making as good as we'd been making.
Yeah, that's right. That's
you know,
pretty
I'd
well
sort
it.
Of done
I mean,
it.
Yeah. I think we could. I think we could do a couple more, but I personally want to move on. That's all.
You just won an award last year, Golden Globe for the television.
That was for Losing Chase.
Right.
Mm.
Great to see you.
You too.
Terry, pleasure to meet you. Terry George directed Some Mother's Son, starring Helen Mirren. We thank you for joining us. We'll see you.